The output of the one-way ANOVA in SPSS provides most of the things you need for reporting. Throughout, please always consider research field-specific reporting standards. First, one formulates whether the groups are different or not, providing the test statistic alongside the degrees of freedom as well as the p-value. I've emphasized why I prefer the robust Welsh ANOVA in the linked video. Therefore, I will report the robust Welsh ANOVA results. In case of calculated post-hoc tests, the observed group differences with a small enough p-value are reported. You can further supplement this with group means or mean differences. When you were able to observe an effect, in your post-hoc testing, also report the calculated effect size, Cohen's D, or Hedges correction of it. It might also be helpful to report the overall effect size of the ANOVA for other researchers having to do an a priori power analysis for their research. Eta-squared or F are the most common ones. Omega-squared is being used more often recently. Finally, you need to classify the magnitude of your effects, especially those observed in post-hoc testing. If similar studies in your research field exist, compare your effect sizes with the given ones. If no comparable study exists, use the common thresholds within your research field. If those are also non-existent, you can always refer to Cohen 92, a power primer.